Allopurinol, how it works in the treatment of gout. Allopurinol is one of the drug that is used to decrease the uric acid levels in the body. So allopurinol can be used in the various conditions like the primary gout, where the uric acid levels are excessively increased, and secondary gout, where it is going to be produced by any disease or a disorder condition. And it is also used as an adjuvant in the cancer chemotherapy. And finally, it can also be used to control the calcium oxalate calculi that can be formed in the renal tubules. So in this way, allopurinol can decrease the uric acid levels in the body, and it can be used in the various clinical conditions. So one of the use of the allopurinol is the primary gout. Primary gout is a condition where there is an overproduction of the uric acid. So this is a metabolic disorder which is associated with the excessive synthesis of the purines followed by their metabolism, leading to increased uric acid levels. One of the enzymes that may be related with this metabolic disorder is the overactivity of the PRPP synthetase enzyme, which is responsible for the increased biosynthesis of the purines in the body, which finally results in the uric acid as the metabolic end product. In this way, primary gout is associated with the excessive levels of the uric acid, where allopurinol is used. Another use of the allopurinol is the secondary gout. So secondary gout is a condition where it is produced by any disease or disorder condition. So few of those conditions like renal failure, diabetes, lactic acidosis, and even the diet which is rich in the purines may increase the uric acid levels in the body. In such conditions, allopurinol can control the uric acid levels. And not only the disease or disorder conditions, some of the drugs can also increase the uric acid levels, which can be controlled by allopurinol. And the role of allopurinol is it is used as an adjuvant in the chemotherapy. Few of the anti-cancer agents may increase the uric acid levels. So with such agents, allopurinol can be given to control the uric acid levels. And finally, allopurinol can also be used in the recurrent calcium oxalate calculi. In such patients, if the uric acid levels are going to be increased, the increased uric acid levels may cause the precipitation of the calcium oxalate crystals in the urine. So in such condition, allopurinol can control the uric acid levels, thereby controls the precipitation of the calcium oxalate crystals in the urine. Now let us see the structure of allopurinol. So this is the structure of allopurinol, and this structure is made up of the fusion of two ring systems. One is the pyrazole and another one is the pyrimidine. So now the allopurinol is going to be fused with the pyrimidine and pyrazole. So that's why allopurinol is called as pyrazolopyrimidine. How allopurinol acts? Now this is the structure of the allopurinol. And allopurinol, when it is administered into the body, it can be converted into another structure by metabolism. Now the allopurinol is going to be converted into its metabolite alloxanthine. Alloxanthine is also called as oxipurinol. We can observe in the structure of the alloxanthine that there is an extra keto group is present which convert the allopurinol into alloxanthine. Now allopurinol is going to inhibit the synthesis of the uric acid, and the metabolite of the allopurinol, oxipurinol, can also inhibit the synthesis of the uric acid. And normally hypoxanthine is going to be converted into xanthine by one of the enzyme xanthine oxidase, and then the xanthine is converted into uric acid by the same enzyme, again the xanthine oxidase. Now both allopurinol as well as oxipurinol going to inhibit this xanthine oxidase enzyme at the two steps, and particularly the activity of oxipurinol is more compared to the allopurinol in the inhibition of the xanthine oxidase enzyme. In this way, allopurinol as well as its metabolite oxipurinol are going to inhibit the uric acid synthesis within the body. Now, hypoxanthine is converted into uric acid, and in this conversion, we can observe that the keto groups are added at the two positions. So hypoxanthine is oxidized to the uric acid, and this step is mediated by one of the enzyme xanthine oxidase. So this xanthine oxidase enzyme is going to be inhibited by allopurinol as well as its metabolite oxipurinol. In this way, allopurinol and oxipurinol will inhibit the conversion of the hypoxanthine to the uric acid, thereby they decrease the uric acid synthesis in the body. How it is given? Allopurinol is given at an initial dose of 100 mg once a daily dose, and the dose can be increased slowly at a weekly basis up to the 300 mg once a daily dose. And according to the situation, the dose can also be increased above the 300 mg, and the maximum dose we can use is the 800 mg per day. What are the side effects of allopurinol? So main side effects of allopurinol are the gastric upset, nausea and diarrhea. So in order to minimize these side effects, the allopurinol is preferably taken after the meal. And these side effects can also be minimized by using the divided doses. This is very important when we are going to use the allopurinol dose above the 300 mg. So when it is used above 300 mg, it should not be given as a single dose, but it should be given as a divided doses given two or thrice daily. And another side effect of allopurinol is the drowsiness, and it can also produce the skin rashes. So this is very important, such that few of the people can observe some hypersensitive reactions when the allopurinol is given. That's why the allopurinol should be avoided in the patients who develop the hypersensitive reactions. And when the allopurinol is used, allopurinol is used in the gout, but it is not used in the acute attack of the gout. And another drug, colchicine, which can be used in the acute attack of the gout. Particularly allopurinol, when it is used in the acute attack, because it is going to decrease the uric acid synthesis, it may cause some compensatory physiological mechanisms which may further increase the uric acid levels within the body. So that's why in the acute attack, allopurinol is not preferred, and it is preferred in the chronic treatment of the gout. And second thing, allopurinol is not a painkiller and it is not an analgesic. It does not decrease the pain in the gouty attack. In order to control the pain, NSAIDs are given in the gouty arthritis. And third important thing is that the allopurinol, because it is going to inhibit the synthesis of the uric acid, it takes few weeks to show its beneficial effects. Since allopurinol is going to inhibit the synthesis of the newly forming uric acid and it is having no action on the already formed uric acid, it takes some time to control the uric acid levels to restore to the normal level. In this way, allopurinol is one of a drug that controls the uric acid levels, but it should be used for a chronic gouty arthritis, as well as it takes some time to produce its beneficial effects on the uric acid levels. Allopurinol is given initially at 100 mg of the dose, and dose can be increased up to the 300 mg or above, but when it is given above 300 mg, the dose should be divided in order to decrease the gastrointestinal side effects. And skin rashes is one more side effect of the allopurinol, which should be checked thoroughly before the administration.